Welcome to the Great Cake Bake, where three fantastically talented and individual cake designers each compete for the job of creating one couple's dream wedding cake. After a whirlwind of consultations and tasting, the couple have to choose their favourite designer. But there's a catch. They don't get to sign off the design or see the cakey creation until the day of their wedding. It could all go horribly wrong. Will there be tears? Well, that depends on the cake design. Today's cake makers are Lindy Adams-Foster from Posh Cakes, Rebecca Smith from Fancy Pants, and Lorna Roberts from Ezzy Cakes, each with very individual styles. Three cake makers, one couple. Who will get a slice of the action? Michelle and Grant met at university. Introduced by their best friends, they hit it off immediately and began dating. Nearly 10 years later, Grant finally plucked up the courage and proposed to a very surprised Michelle. They've chosen to get married at a boutique hotel in Tavistock, Devon, called Brown's.
The engagement was quite romantic. I've kind of been teasing you to do it, but I'd kind of given up. So I wasn't expecting it at all, and it was on Christmas Eve.
The two dogs we've got are a big part of our lives, so I wanted to kind of include them in it, and also something I didn't think she'd expect. One of them had the ring around her neck, and another had the marry me on a balloon around her neck. And basically I went in the room with the first one with a ring. Michelle opened the ring, and in perfect timing the next one came in with a marry me balloon. That was which when I got down on one knee.
I got out of bed and said, of course I will. And Minnie and Bailey were really excited, weren't they, jumping all around. I'd never really thought about having a winter wedding before, but it kind of all tied in with the engagement and everything. So we haven't gone for an overly Christmas theme, have we? But we've kind of kept it to like a wintry wonderland, with the colours being like hot pinks and purples, like Christmas jewels, and kind of included snowflakes on our invitations and things like that. So we're having the ceremony and the reception at Brown's, which is a place that we've been to quite a few times. We just feel really comfortable there.
For like a winter wedding, it's sort of really quaint, really nice wooden beams, roaring fire, and just for that time of year we thought it would be perfect.
The dream wedding cake for me is something that obviously ties in with our theme, so not anything overly Christmas or kind of tacky, but really magical, stylish. With other aspects of the wedding, like the venue and the dress, I kind of saw the dress and knew immediately, and it was the same with the venue for us, wasn't it? But the cake was the one aspect that I was a bit unsure of what kind of route to go down. So I'm really looking forward to kind of the ideas that the cake designers are going to have for us.
We've been in control of obviously most of the day, haven't we?
Yeah.
So this would be nice, you know, almost like an extra surprise, maybe like an extra sort of present for us on the day.
It's the day of the consultations, and the first cake maker the couple are to meet is Lindy Adams-Foster from Devon-based Posh Cakes.
My cakes are known for style and elegance. They've always got a modern, quirky twist to them, and I pride myself in that the cake will be totally individual. My favourite cake, or cakes I should say, if I could give you two, one would be my original signature cake, really, which is a sandcastle cake. And my second most favourite cake is my ultimate butterfly cake. A wedding cake should hopefully reflect the bride and groom and what they are, their inner soul and thoughts and for their day. My aim when a bride and groom come and see me is that at the end of the day, I want them to walk away happy. Even though I'm not going to be able to discuss all the intricacies of the cake design with them, which I would normally do, so that's the scary part, but I do feel confident I can produce something that they will be gobsmacked.
They head to her home to find out about her artistic and stylish way of creating wedding cakes.
Wow. Well, thank you very much for coming to see me. As you possibly can see from the cakes that I've got here and from what I've showing you now, that I would say to you that my style of cakes was very elegant, very classy, very intricate, and very different. I've got a chocolate sponge cake with just chocolate buttercream on it.
Mm.
That is the lemon cake.
So it's nice and moist.
Mm. very tasty.
Every client that comes to me, they know they're going to have an individual bespoke cake that nobody else is going to get.
That's something obviously we'd really like, and we're actually focusing a lot on the day that yes. with the unveiling of the cake. So I mean, obviously that is a wow factor. Mm. So I think I definitely like something that the bigger the better that people are going to think right. of. You know, Grant's a Man City fan, so right. he originally wanted right. the colour scheme to be sky blue. But
well, that went out the window pretty quickly.
I think that would have been nice if it was a summer wedding.
What I understand you're looking for your dream cake is the theme is winter, but not obviously winter, with hot pink, purple, gold, jewel colours, and possibly some snowflakes. Not tacky, but will be a huge amount of fun.
Can't wait to see you.
Thank you.
Absolute yeah, pleasure to meet, you.
You.
I hope that you know I get to see you again.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay then. Thank you very much.
That went really, really well. It was really positive.
And she really listened to what we kind of were asking and kind of put together really what I was kind of thinking from looking through her work.
I felt really happy about it. Really happy. I wanted to give them a big hug and show them my pictures, but I can't.
This is the first one. I thought it was great. The other two have obviously got a lot to live up to.
Yeah,
so
that's
far.
It. It's made me even more excited now.
Next up is Rebecca Smith from Plymouth-based Fancy Pants Cakes. Maybe Rebecca's creative and stylish cakes will grab the couple's attention.
Fancy Pants Cakes is known for the different type of cakes, where you traditional with a bit of a twist. I love it when brides come to me and they ask for something a bit different and crazy and can you make this? And I'm like, oh my God, yeah, I think I can. My favourite type of cakes to make are the wonky, colourful and all a bit topsy-turvy as though it's not quite stood up straight. A wedding cake should be well finished, the icing should be perfectly smooth and everything else, but there isn't a particular style that is proper. It's just up to the bride and groom what they choose, really. Brides and grooms usually like to know what they're getting. It's always quite nerve-wracking to drop it off and think, oh God, they've not said whether they liked it or not. But then I always get phone calls or I get little cards and things, which is quite nice. I love decorating cakes. I love making them, baking them, eating them, everything. I don't like chopping them up once I've created them. It's just always been there. It's always been my hobby. I just love it.
Hi, I'm Michelle.
Hi, nice to meet you, I'm Becky.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, Becky Grant. Hiya. Thanks for having us.
How would you sum up your style of work, do you think?
Well, this is some of my ideas okay. that I, well, some of my things I've done in the past, so you can see my type of work.
Yeah, you're going.
I tend to do, like, the topsy-turvy, like, the cakes are always different sizes, or if you don't like that, we can just do nice deep cakes yeah. and thin cakes and deep cakes.
I think for us, we're looking for something more along the lines of the quirky style rather than the traditional.
I really like that cake over there, so that's really unusual. Really draws
really
your
nice,
eye to it.
Isn't
yeah.
it? A bit different.
Really attractive cake.
Do you like the idea of different things on each tier?
That one's nice, how you've done the other stripes and obviously done the spots.
Yeah, and instead of like the spots, we could maybe put snowflakes.
Right, yeah.
I've got some bits for you to taste right. if you want to yeah. taste them. This is fruit cake, carrot cake, chocolate cake and vanilla sponge.
Do you want to go for the
chocolate cake?
Chocolate yeah. one, yeah. It's really light and airy, those cakes, aren't they?
I like that.
Right, I think I've got a kind of an idea of what we could go for. If we go for like a four-tier cake, go for whites and purpley colours icings, have your snowflakes, your diamonds, and then some birds or something on the top to bring in the Christmassy dove theme.
That sounds really good, like really tie in with our theme.
Yeah.
So it's right from the invites all the way through.
Yeah, ideal.
Today it's been, you know, kind of quirky, but still elegant and a bit more fun involved.
I think the couple were in tune with what I was like presenting to them.
It's really kind of opened our eyes to a whole new way of thinking with the cake.
Not many people get married at Christmas, so it's nice to do something that isn't a Christmassy theme, but is the Winter Wonderland theme.
And finally, it's the turn of Lorna Roberts from Ezzy Cakes, who is also based in Plymouth. Her approach to wedding cakes is a unique and abstract style.
Ezzy Cakes is known for artist-made cakes and a unique bespoke design that's very contemporary, with obviously elements of traditional wedding cakes. I'm actually an artist, and it's the artistic design and the thinking outside of the cake box that makes us different. When I'm creating a wedding cake for a bride and groom, I hope to achieve them as people within the design, so that all their guests and friends and family can look at that cake and it will just fit in perfectly and beautifully with everything that they're wearing, everything that they are, everything they believe in, and it should just be literally the icing on the cake. It should just be their baby.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Michelle. Hi, Donna. Nice to meet you.
Hi, wow, look at them.
Sit down.
Oh, wow.
Let's sit again.
Yeah. Thank you.
There's mainly here I've got vanilla, chocolate, lemon, raspberry and white chocolate, and I have got fruit, and I've got a rainbow cake over here with a butterfly on. And this has just got like a thin layer of buttercream on, so.
Yeah. Wow, see, it does look really good fun, that, doesn't it?
Yeah, so if you had a completely all white cake and then you cut into it and you had all your colours, your guests would think that was quite cool, I think. It looks like it would taste of different flavours, but it just tastes of vanilla.
That is absolutely amazing.
Would you like to try lemon? Or
yeah,
raspberry and white chocolate.
I'd definitely like to try the raspberry and white chocolate.
Yeah,
that's
okay,
one.
Yeah.
That's one we've not come across before.
Yeah, it's like those big those cookies that you get, the raspberry and the white chocolate. Yeah.
I'd definitely like to have something like that.
Yeah.
Or the pinks and purples.
It's going to be getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
Well, that's it. So have you got some images of you or photos of your
past
work? Yes,
I've got some photographs of work I've done before. This is quite recent, actually. It was based on the lady's wedding dress.
I was just going to say that.
When I looked at that dress, I could, like, my brain was ticking. Even the Toastmaster said that it's the best cake he'd ever seen and he sees them every day, so I was really pleased.
It's nice,
that
isn't it?
Nice,
really, really pleased. Okay, so I've got quite a good idea of what you're looking at and the elements to include. The first thing that comes to mind is the kind of snow white, glistening kind of feel on a cake that's rather tall and elegant as well. Possibly sort of linking in and around snowflakes and baubles coming down the side.
That sounds great, doesn't it? Sounds like it'd be something really different but beautiful and really unique all at the same time.
Yeah, I can see it.
I just wish we could see it. Yeah. It sounds absolutely amazing. Totally open our eyes up again if that could be possible from the past two cake designers that we've been to.
I was really pleased because they were lovely. And they said everything I wanted them to say.
It's going to be a hard decision to make, I think.
Yeah, I mean, they're all absolutely fantastic, really talented, creative, and have all got their own ideas. So it's going to be really hard to pick something when we haven't actually seen what the final cake is going to look like.
So Michelle and Grant have seen all three cake makers, and they now have the difficult task of deciding who will make their Winter Wonderland wedding cake, combining dual colours and snowflake details. Coming up after the break, which cake maker will Michelle and Grant choose to take their very wintry ideas forward to create their dream cake? Welcome to the Great Cake Bake, where three fantastically talented and very individual cake designers compete for the job of creating one couple's dream wedding cake. After a day of consultations and stuffing their faces with cake, they now have to decide who impressed them the most. Who will get the job of creating their five-tier Winter Wonderland themed wedding cake?
Just really, really excited now, even more for, you know, the unveiling on the day, because I think we're just going to get something really special and different.
I thought Lindy's approach was really, really thorough. She went into a lot of detail with everything, trying to get sort of the best information from us to make the best possible cake.
To be honest, coming away from Lindy's, we kind of thought, so I don't know how anybody else could kind of top it, really. I mean, her work's outstanding and they tasted really lovely as well.
Rebecca kind of had sort of a different path to go down with sort of different designs from Lindy, and her stuff was sort of quite fun.
What I really think is clever about Rebecca is she could kind of do anything, really. She could do the really traditional cakes as well as doing completely different fun cakes. You know, she could kind of do the whole spectrum, really.
Lorna's cakes were absolutely amazing. Once again, she had even sort of more designs and styles that we'd never even imagined. And then on top of that, she also had different flavours that I never would have thought of.
From the moment we walked in, I mean, the effort that she'd gone into to make all the individual cakes and ice them all, I mean, it must have taken her hours. Can't we have all of them? I think we're going to have to... Do you have one in your head that you're edging more towards?
I do have one, yeah.
I think I do as well. I wonder if it's the same.
Will it be Lindy Adams Foster from Posh Cakes, Rebecca Smith from Fancy Pants, or Lorna Roberts from Ezzy Cakes?
Hello, is that Lorna?
Hi, speaking.
Hello, this is Michelle and Grant here from The Great Cake Bake.
Hi.
So we're just phoning because we've had to make our decision.
Okay.
And we've decided to pick you. Okay.
Best cake that anyone's ever seen.
I'm sure it will.
Have the best day ever.
Oh, thank you ever so much, and I'm sure we'll be in touch soon.
We've definitely made the right decisions, no doubt in my mind,
yeah.
At all.
It's just a few weeks until the wedding of Michelle and Grant takes place. And with such a large and intricate cake to make, Lorna sets to work.
To give the cake a wow factor, I want the cake to be large. I'm going to use hot pink and purple swirled together with a marble effect so that when the cake's cut open, you've got the wow factor on the inside as well as the outside. Today, I'm going to be making some of the snowball cakes. I'm going to be doing some vanilla ones. And I'm going to be using a half round cake tray. I bake them, level the tops off, and then stick them together to create the snowball. I've already decorated this part of the cake completely in white now. They would like some colour in their cake, so I am going to add some tiny details of colour with these tiny little snowflakes. It's a massive project, but I will not let that cake out of my house until I know that it's perfect.
It's the day of Michelle and Grant's wedding, and everyone is busy at the wedding venue with the flowers and decorations for the couple's dual-coloured and Winter Wonderland-themed wedding. Meanwhile, Lorna is finishing the cake and boxing it up, ready to be transported to the wedding venue, where the couple will see it for the very first time.
Once the cake was finished, I felt a bit more relaxed. And then when I looked at it this morning, I thought, I've actually got to pack that into boxes and take it. I got really nervous again. My husband, Ed, is going to help me carry the boxes and drive me to the wedding. He is so nervous about doing it. He normally doesn't like to get involved with any of the cake things because he's worried that he's going to be at fault if something breaks. But someone's got to help me because I can't do it myself.
Michelle and Grant's family and friends are gathered at the hotel for the ceremony. And after nearly 10 years of waiting, Michelle finally gets her man.
I, Grant Mills.
Do take you, Michelle Brunger.
Do take you, Michelle Brunger.
From this day forward.
I will love and comfort you.
I will love and comfort you.
Hold you close.
Hold you close.
You may now kiss your beautiful bride.
Oh, grab the tissues, everyone. While the happy couple sign the register and mingle with their guests, Lorna arrives at the wedding venue, cake boxed and ready to be constructed, and she has just a few hours.
It's all fine, nothing's happened to it. Now the difficult bit is getting it actually onto the top of the cake.
While Lorna constructs the cake and makes sure everything has arrived undamaged, Michelle and Grant head off to the roof to have their photos taken.
If I could ask you all to be upstanding for the entrance of the bride and groom.
Absolutely amazing, hasn't it?
Yeah, from start to finish, it's been brilliant, as we expected. Probably more than we expected, to be honest. Everything's gone to plan.
Yeah, everybody's managed to make it, haven't they?
Yeah.
Even though there's been the snow, which has been fantastic.
I promise to be faithful to you, to nurture you, to cherish you, to appreciate you.
My favourite part of the day so far is the ceremony. It was even more special than I could imagine. It's obviously quite emotional, especially for my dad getting really emotional. And I really loved, obviously, what Grant said to me, and it just felt really magical and intimate, and that everyone was close, but it was just really special. So that was definitely my favourite bit.
Lorna adds the final touches to her amazing snowball creation.
So yeah, I'm really pleased. I've sort of filled in all the gaps and stacked it, and I'm just so pleased it's made it. I had this idea that the cake should be mounted on a sort of pile of snow. Obviously, we can't use the real snow. So I've found in a sort of children's toy shop this kind of fake snow, and you mix it with water, and I've put a little bit of glitter with it.
to make it look really sparkly. And I've got this idea of putting kind of fairy lights underneath and then packing the snow around it, and hopefully they'll shine through so it looks like it's kind of floating on this bed of snow.
Let's hope it lives up to the couple's expectations, as it's a very important part of their day.
I'm expecting it to be big, but other than that, I kind of try not to think about it too much, so I'm not expecting anything. I know with her passion and enthusiasm, it's probably going to be even better than anything she's done before, so...
I'm sure it'll taste great, it'll look amazing, and it'll really steal the show, that's what I'm thinking.
So, after weeks of hard work, Lorna's moment has arrived. It's time for Michelle, Grant and their 140 guests to see the bespoke wedding cake she's created for them. No pressure then.
I'm starting to get a bit nervous again because they're going to come see it in a minute and I really hope they like it.
Wow, look at that.
Oh my God.
Is that going to taste as good as it looks?
Oh my God, absolutely.
That's fantastic.
Five tiers high, four different flavours and covered in edible chocolate snowballs.
Oh wow.
That's all right, you're welcome. Congratulations.
Thank you, that was absolutely fantastic. Thanks for getting over here.
You've got all your flavours there. You've got vanilla, chocolate, you've got the swirled hot pink and purple. You've got your raspberry and white chocolate. A nice tall one. And every snowball has got chocolate cake inside.
Oh. Thank you, that's absolutely amazing. Thank you. I knew you'd come up with something to start this world.
It's so pretty and like wintery.
I went with your Winter Wonderland theme.
Brilliant, right.
And also the fact that it's a week before Christmas, I went with the kind of bows, the presents and right. the kind of romance of it all. And I thought that it would, you know, perhaps go with your dress with the kind of light crossovers.
Unveiling over, and Michelle and Grant now have to cut the cake as everyone's desperate to taste Lorna's amazing creation.
The cake looks absolutely fantastic. It tastes beautiful, looks really nice, really fits our theme, doesn't it? Matches your dress almost.
Yeah, and just really pretty and subtle hints of like the you know, the colour scheme, but lovely like with the snowballs and it's really wintery and...
I don't think she could have made anything better that matched what today was all about, really.
Definitely not, yeah. No.
I mean, off it's already nearly gone because people keep putting up for more and more.
Yeah, I think all the kids love it, especially, don't yeah. they?
It went a lot better than I could have ever expected it. I was so pleased that they liked it.
I'm really pleased we chose Lorna to do the cake. I think we knew straight away that she was the one we wanted, and definitely she's proved it tonight because, like I say, that cake's just out of this world.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we had no doubts, did we, when we'd picked Lorna, that she was going to be the right one for us, and she's done more than we ever expected, really.
The cake's absolutely amazing. It's so pretty and it fits in really well with their theme. It's just really lovely.
Absolutely beautiful. Amazed. We didn't imagine, we didn't know what it was going to be like. It's absolutely fantastic.
Everybody is just saying how fantastic it is and it's the best cake that they've ever seen. So just real big thank you to her, really.
All of that tastes absolutely fantastic. Thank you, Emerson.
It's so moist. It's absolutely better than I could ever imagine.
Well, the biggest one ever. They seem to really understand everything I put into it and that I put all their ideas into it. And it really matched her dress, which was really nice because I hadn't obviously seen her dress. So that worked really well. And I'm just absolutely relieved that it's over.
Well, it seems that everyone is snowballed over by Lorna's beautiful cake. Just one last thing to do. Eat cake, drink, and be merry.